Hello guys, in this tutorial I'm going to show you how to create a wheel arches for a car. So you have a standby to make a fully created car. So right now I'm going to continue on, and first I'm going to delete. I'm going to show you just a moment, and later on I will delete on this wheel arches. So as you can see from if I press F front end, you can see that the wheel arches is arching, or it's curving right, start from the middle and go down to the bottommost part. So I'm going to go back to the perspective view. As you can see, so right now we are going to create this kind of wheel arches. So I'm going to start right now. Okay, so I'm going to like this and delete. And I'm going to go to the left view and press G and Z to zoom. Then I'm going to select on tube. Go to create, and then select geometry and select tube. From here, go to the center, pull this off, and make the width of it, and then make the height of it. So there is a three. Segment section that you need to do. So right now, as you can see, I'm going to turn off the grid by pressing G, and then right now I'm going to go to the modify panel, and then select side from 12 to 24. And as you can see, this is this all polygon count on the left side is on the 24 count. So I'm going to keep the height segment 1 and cap segment 1, and then just click on it, and then right click, convert to editable poly, and click on the plus button, click on the polygon, and bring them, select, shift select, bring an element, select element on the, and click on the side element that we don't need, and delete this. And go to the polygon and go to the left side and go press F3 for a better viewing for the segment. And we need to delete eight of this, and then so we left over with here, as you can see, it's 16 polygons selected. So it's 16 left. So right now, I'm going to select on the bottommost part of the segment, and then I'm going to press Y, and then I'm going to reposition it, and press Y, and reposition it, press Y, reposition it, press Y once again, and reposition it. And I think that's good. So right now go to the perspective view. As you can see, it's we already made an arches, but the arches from the side view. But if you go to the front view, it's completely flat. So that's why we need to create curve on it. So we need to go to the perspective view and then go there, go to the element, and select all of them, and then we go to the disk modifier list tab. So we're going to click this down arrow and go there and search for FFD box. There you go, FFD box, select them. So go to the control point and click plus on this FFD box 4x4x4x4x4. Then go to the front view by pressing F, and select the control point, and press W to move, and then we move it slightly. We're not going to move the this control point because it's not enough of a control point, so we only need this and this to be moved inside. And go to the perspective view once again, and as you can see, everything is looks fine. Right click on it, convert to editable poly. So right now you have wheel arch, but some couple thing you need to fix is the one that right here. Go here and then we constrain edges, and then just move it up a little bit because of the transformations. So make it more proportional. It's already there. So go to constraints and go to none. Just move it back a little bit. So move it front a little bit. Okay, so if I press on the front view, as you can see, the arch is showing right there. So go to the perspective view once again. And right now I'm going to select element and none, instead of none, and then shift select and pull them back to where approximately, and select clone a part of mesh as a clone to element, and make the rear side of the wheel arches. And I'm going to select this, and I'm going to select in the front right there, and then close the, minimize the edit geometry, and the edit edges, go to bridges, and select the, select the bottom part, and then bridges, so bridge, so all of them is now bridge, so right now it is very flat, as you can see from side view. It's completely flat. All I'm going to do is to create a much more dynamic shape on this side skirt. So go to the perspective and go to constrain edges. Oops, and move them in the Y direction. The Z direction. Right there. So it's going up. Move right here. Move right there. So make it proportional. So right there in the middle. Go and select that. Move a little bit. And then oops, go to do that. First go to select one of them and shift select edges, select one edges, and then shift select all of them will be continuously selected. So shift select, push them in. And then tonality of 3. And then go to the other one and select all of them and collapse all this. Go to the polygon smoothing groups, clear all, click 1 and go to the polygon and then select all the one that stay behind the wheel arches, and then we select this as a number 2 in the polygon smoothing group and select this and turn off the 1, make it this under 3 groups of the smoothing groups, and now we are going to select this down arrow and go to the turbo smooth by pressing T, find turbo smooth, and then we are going to turn on the smoothing group, and then make it 2. So you can see now you have done and you have created a new wheel arches. A proper wheel arches. So thank you guys for watching. I will see you in the next video to continue on this object to finish this project. So I will continue on and see you in the next video. Thank you.